It's a great pleasure for me to speak in this great university and to share views on energy union. If you would look at different aspects of European life, energy is probably one of the better examples where our cooperation is more or less successful. Or maybe we can even call it a successful cooperation. If you would look at refugee crisis and other political issues which are up to date in Europe, Europe is not that united, but we should look at the better examples to show that there are areas where we can cooperate, appreciate what we have achieved, and then extrapolate this good achievement into the other areas. And I am pretty sure that Europe will survive those challenges which we are facing today. And personally, I also believe in challenges, as history shows, and many of you can witness in your private lives, what does not break you would make you. Everybody of us needs a certain test in our lives to see what we're made of and whether we're capable to withstand difficulties. And normally, humanity was going out stronger out of each and single problem. If you would look at the nature, I just observed a TV program on the forest, that there are parts of the world where is a very natural way of life is forest fires. But what actually happens that forest fires are helping to develop that parts of the world to for new forest to grow. And without forest fires, there would be no possibility to get a new life, because there are certain seeds which can be planted only during the fire, and they can be activated during the fire, and then they give growth to other seeds. So I believe that certain problems which we are facing now in Europe will make us stronger in the future, and would like to look at it from positive point of view. And energy union is one of those good examples where we are advancing in stronger relations. And I will later on tell you shortly on that. Why do we need a stronger energy union? A stronger energy union would make whole Europe stronger. Energy makes such a big part of our lives, such an important part of our lives. And it is so interrelated with politics and geopolitics that sometimes you cannot separate politics from the energy politics, because it is one and the same thing. If you would look at actions, for example, how Russia is acting, so aggressiveness goes not only in the battlefield, but aggressiveness goes also in the energy field, in blockage of sources of supply, of planning and scheming different ways of energy supplies, blocking energy supplies to the countries we would like to punish, and so on and so forth. So energy is a very, very important part of the politics. So having a strong and united energy policy, Europe makes sure that Europe as a union gets stronger. Energy union is built on five pillars. And Lithuania is actually a very, very good example. When you look at this slide, all five pillars are very important for us, and on all five aspects we can tell something. In general, I'm very, very proud of my country and what we have achieved in the energy field. From being 100%, I would say, 100% dependent on Russian energy supplies, be it oil, gas, or electricity, maybe electricity lower, up to 60% after we have closed Ignalina nuclear power plant, but still going so strong after that and determining to of building our strategic infrastructure project, committing and finally executing it in a good fashion, in a cost-safely fashion, and achieving not only energy security but also favorable energy prices comparing to the past. Lithuania has showed not only to Europe but to the world that if somebody is dedicated enough, if somebody has a strong will, can make changes and can make things different and can actually achieve things. So in this sense, energy is adding to the self-esteem, to the self-belief for Lithuania, that we in Lithuania are capable of changing things and building future by ourselves, for ourselves, and maybe helping others who would like to learn from our example. Going into the details, into each of the aspects, first of all, we need to mention energy security, because that was on the lips of Lithuanian energy professionals for quite a few years until now. Now we can conclude that Lithuania has almost reached energy security, energy independence. Even our latest energy strategy was named Energy Independence Strategy, just to make it stronger and for us to all understand what we're trying to achieve. We have built an LNG terminal, we have built power links to Sweden and to Poland. Before, we have built an oil terminal in the Baltic Sea, Būtingė oil terminal. We have strengthened our internal network, be it electricity, be it gas. We are planning to build a pipeline to Poland, so-called GIPL, which will suddenly, out of nothing, would make Lithuania and the whole region very vibrant, very active in the energy field. We would be able to share electricity with the whole region, we would be able to share gas with the whole region, and the whole region would become an active energy hub. And looking forward, I believe that there will be a possibility for our specialists, for our universities to develop specific knowledge, specific experience in the energy fields, where we would have ingrown home technologies which we would be able to sell, to share with others. So looking from there, we should have as ambitious as possible plans for our country to grow in the energy field and simultaneously for the whole country to grow. I'm very happy that by building energy security, by building energy integration, we have grown in much better relations with our neighbors. I would be as brave to say, but I think, and I think personally, that our relations with Latvians and Estonians have never been better, what we have now. It's very normal that neighbors are disagreeing on some things, but what we have now, for example, last year, Latvian Minister of Economy arranged a trip of three ministers of Baltic countries to Brussels, and we have presented our single position on synchronization with desynchronization from Russian electricity grid and synchronization with the European energy network. We have clearly declared that three countries have the same interest. We are growing in understanding with Poland on the need of connecting Baltic countries into the continental network, and I see those relations also grow in trust, in understanding. So believe that energy also can serve in this matter as well. In the energy security, as I told, three most important projects which we have made is oil terminal in the Baltic Sea, Būtingė terminal, LNG terminal in Klaipėda port, pictured on the slide, and electrical grids to want to overhead power line to Poland and cable to Sweden. Integration, something you can easily grasp what Europe is talking about when we talk energy union. In order to be more united, we have to have more connections. And integration is connections between European countries. There are missing links between number of regions in Europe, be it gas, be it electricity. One of the good examples is Baltic states. We were an energy island before, and still in a certain extent, since we're working in synchronized regime with Russia still. But for example, if you take Iberian Peninsula, France and Spain has very, very weak connections. So this is not a question only for Baltic states, but also for other European countries. And if you would go around Europe, we would suddenly realize that Europe is not very well connected. When Europe is not very well connected, we cannot share resources. When we cannot share resources, we're not flexible. When we're not flexible, we're depending on external powers, for example, on Russia. Russia can play one country after another. But if we are connected, and for example, Spain currently has huge overcapacities in LNG terminals, so Spain can be a big supply of gas into Europe, and that would be a perfect competition to Nord Stream 2, but there are no connections between Spain and France, or very, very limited. So Spain cannot be a supplier of gas into Europe just because of that. Even though they had such a good and such well-developed infrastructure in gas, one of the best examples in Europe. So building interconnections would make us all stronger when we can share resources. In Baltic countries, for us, is the most important left work is synchronization. In our view, the best way of synchronization is synchronizing with continental European network. As you can build strong overhead power lines, which have a reliable connection to European network. And gas grid with Poland would connect Baltic countries to European gas grid as well. Then we would be able to have another alternative gas supply over Poland. Then Estonia will connect to Finland. Finland would be connected as well. And this is another missing link in the gas sector. BEMIP, Baltic Energy Market Interconnection Plan, is one of the best examples in Europe, and it was, if I'm not mistaken, it was named the best or one of the best regional cooperation examples. So again, there is something we can show that Baltic countries, Poland, Sweden, and other countries sharing Baltic Sea demonstrated that we can be united when it is needed. And again, this format BEMIP was so successful that even tasks from BEMIP were being implemented. BEMIP 2 was relaunched. And BEMIP 2 includes synchronization as well. So it shows that there are possibilities to have regional plans which are working, which show that Europe is working. And this is again a good example how Europeans can cooperate. Energy efficiency, something what we're lagging behind. Energy efficiency is one of the top priorities for Lithuania now. And we should be much stronger and much more efficient in it. Cheapest energy is one which has never been used, so we should save as much as in energy as we can. Since Lithuania is almost overall net importer of energy, except of our biomass and wind production, the rest comes as an import. we need to reducing energy consumption also helps on our current account deficit and makes our country financially stronger. So this those projects of energy efficiency are top priority for us. In the Ministry of Energy, we have compiled a plan how energy efficiency should be proceeded in Lithuania, and a special law will have to be adopted in the parliament in first half of this year. So this is one of the area for improvement for us, I should say. We are lagging a little bit behind, especially in the renovation of the old dwelling houses. Decarbonization, again, Lithuania is one of the leaders in European Union. We have achieved our plan set for 2020 already now. We had to achieve 23% of green energy production out of total mix. We have achieved it in the beginning of this year. We had to produce 23% green energy, and we're planning that by 2020 we will achieve 30%. It opens us a possibility to trade over achievements and maybe possibly have a certain gain to our country by selling it to the countries which are lagging behind. So again, another pillar where Lithuania is standing strong, and we will continue on decarbonizing our economy. Conclusion, it should be said that there are certain areas for improvement for us and for Europe overall. But there is sometimes a moment when you can sit and relax a little bit and enjoy what has been achieved. So certainly we have earned a certain aspect of looking back and what has been achieved and enjoying it. But this pause shouldn't take too long, and we should go further. And this, as it was mentioned already here today, Lithuania needs to think on building and getting stronger on local generation. This is again one more aspect where we need to get stronger. So not too much time to relax, but certainly we need to spend some time enjoying what has been achieved. Thank you very much.